Congratulations to my friend Jay-Z on this incredible honor. I've always said the two of us have more in common than meets the eye. Nobody who met either of us as younger men would have expected us to be where we are today. We both feel a sense of responsibility to create ladders of opportunity for those who are coming up behind us. And let's face it, we also both have wives who are significantly more popular than we are. In part because we've been on similar journeys, I've turned to Jay-Z's words at different points in my life, whether I was brushing dirt off my shoulder on the campaign trail or sampling his lyrics on the Edmund Pettus Bridge on the 50th anniversary of the Selma March to Montgomery. Today, Jay-Z is one of the most renowned artists in history and an embodiment of the American dream, a dream he has helped make real for other young people like him. So let me be one of the first to welcome Hove, the kid from Marcy Houses, to HOF as an official Rock and Roll Hall of Famer. It's a testament to one of the most remarkable careers in the history of music, a career whose story is still being written. Congratulations, Jay.
In my lifetime, more than a million rhymes. No joking.
Hey, Jay, can I get open?
Beyond reasonable doubt, the industry made me wait.
What's crazy is I'm still spending money from 88.
Can I live and surprise the game? Think harder.
You know this, brother.
Jay-Z.
Sean Carter.
Brooklyn.
Marcy.
Where friends or foes can get it quick.
So I suggest you all roll with the click, bitch. Who you with?
It's all right. Just use your wits.
To know the difference between a 4.0 and a 4.6.
Young Hove, and you can feel every word like Braille.
I'm a hustler, baby.
I can sell water to a well.
The Mike Jordan of recording.
The truth's in every word.
Yeah, it's a hard knock life,
but it's all right. You heard?
When the Remy's in the system, hear the track and take flight.
I'm a business man. He who writes checks with the hand that don't write.
Okay, I'm reloaded.
With too many classics.
It's the ROC. And we running this rap shit.
My flow is liable to go Michael. Take your pick.
Jackson, Tyson, Jordan, game six.
In the zone like 2-3. It made it look too easy.
Can't leave rap alone. The game needs me.
I'm from the other side where other guys are quick to pull your card.
And argue about who's the best MC.
Biggie.
Jay-Z.
And Nas.
Man, the average rap fan couldn't pick just one of the three.
It's cool. I'm out for dead presidents to represent me.
The takeover, the break's over.
So you can get
that
dirt off your shoulder.
Cause if I hit you, I'm brainless.
Now if you get me, you're famous. What's a brother to do?
Damn. It gets tedious.
So I keep one eye open, like CBS.
I'm focused, man.
This is a one of one.
The hustler's poster child.
I'll show you how to do this, son.
So you can see what was what?
And who was who?
All the way from 444
to 4040s.
Down to 22 twos.
Told y'all, nobody wins when the family feuds.
My motto is simple. I will not lose.
Allow me to reintroduce myself. My name is Hove. H to the O-V.
Leader of the Black Gang, R-O-C, man.
They say words are a weapon.
So when I shoot, meet your death in less than 8 seconds.
I'm from a place where the news cameras never come.
Where you can have 99 problems, but a bitch ain't one.
H to the Izzo,
V to the Izzy.
Yeah, I'm out that, Brooklyn.
Always see me reppin' BK.
Cause you can't knock the hustle.
So all we ask is trust.
That's why I'm overcharging them for what they did to the Cold Crush.
First off, I want to thank my connects, dude.
Cause what's better than one black billionaire?
Two.
They said I couldn't do it again, so I did it again.
Only rapper to rewrite history with no pen.
Jigga, man, we did it, man. History made. You got to feel him.
No more Big Willie. My game is grown. Prefer you call me William.
And if you can't respect that, then your whole perspective is whack. Maybe you'll love me when I fade to black.
You witnessing the blueprint of how to pitch with no mound.
So gather round, hustlers, cause it's about to go down.
Congrats us, Carter, Ghost Rider,
You paid the right price, so we just made your hits tighter.
To induct Jay-Z, Dave Chappelle.
OH. I would like to apologize to the, I'm just fucking with you, it's not okay. This is an incredible honor to induct this next man into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. But I need everybody in rock and roll to know that even though you are honoring him, he is ours. He is hip hop forever and ever and a day. I could sit up here tonight. I could talk about his acumen as a businessman. I could talk about his accomplishments in music. But I think what's most important for everyone in this room to know is what he means to us, what he means to his culture. Being black in America is not as easy as it looks. There's always an or else. Don't do this. Or else, don't say this, or else. But like Sean Carter said about himself, I'm so brazen. I'm raising in the sun, sir. We do it anyway, whenever we have to. We don't have a complicated emotional vocabulary. We have to make everything look easy. And this man is a diamond that was born of pressure. To coin a phrase that a fellow Hall of Famer made, Tupac Shakur, he called it a rose that grows from the concrete. And that to us is what hip hop is. We heard our stories come back to us, our stresses and our strife. And the whole time that he said it, my God, Jay, you look so cool. You look so calm and so collected. If I shoot you, I'm brainless. But if you shoot me, you're famous. What a nigga to do, my God, man. It was beautiful to watch. In the music industry, they call him One Take Hov. He said it about himself, but you don't know why he said it. Because when he was hustling, because he used to sell crack. Oh, don't get it twisted. American pie is not made out of apples. It's made out of whatever you can get your fucking hands on. He used to sell crack. He didn't have anything to write his rhymes on, and he would sit there and he would just memorize all these thoughts that came to his mind, an avalanche of ideas, and he would just be catching rainwater. And when he got in the studio, like God, he would do the verse, he would let it be, and it would be. And the streets admire him for this. Streets love him for this, because he rhymed a recipe for survival. The way a white person might hear his music is not the same the way someone from Marcy would. When he said, this is Jay every day, when he told us he'd never change, you heard this, and he probably said, as a white person, well, maybe this guy should focus on his development. But what we heard is he will never forget us. He will always remember us, that we are his point of reference, that he is going to show us how far we can go if we just get hold of the opportunity. And for this, we will always love him, and we will always treasure him. And as important as this award is to some, you must understand that he has his people's heart, that we love him more than you could ever recognize him for or even realize, because he embodies the potential of what our lives can be. and what success can be. There's so much poetry if you got to know him, and just the way he speaks. I remember one time, the Roots was having a jam session in LA. Hello, Amir. And backstage, I saw Jay-Z, and a photographer came up and said, "Guys, can we get a picture?" It was him and his wife, Beyonce. And we all right, guys, relax, would you? And we all grouped together for a picture, me, Jay, and Beyonce. And I stood between them, and I put my arms around him, and Jay grabbed me and moved me to the side and grabbed his wife by the hand and said, "The rose between the thorns." And as they're taking a picture, Jay says to me, "You must have a lot of pressure on you to say funny shit all the time." And I looked at Jay and I said, "Well, you must have a lot of pressure on you to say cool shit all the time." And Jay looked at me and said, "It ain't no pressure, I just do it." That's right. And I looked at Jay and said, "My God, man, you just did it again." Hove, I'm your friend and your fan. I'm honored that I got a chance to know you. You embody Black excellence, how great we can be, and I am honored to be the nigga that gets to say to my nigga, welcome to the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
You last 3 years in hip hop, you're fantastic. You last 5 years, it's like, wow, it's amazing. But if you last through a decade and beyond, it's almost unheard of.
Now tuned into the motherfucking greatest. If you
feeling like a pimp, nigga, gone, brush your shoulders off. When you say top five, top three, Jay is at the top of most people's list.
Charisma, storytelling, wordplay, the ability to make you think. You take all those things and you execute it at the highest level. That's Jay. Make some noise out
there. What makes a rapper great is how close he can bring you to his experience. Like you can just close your eyes and you just right there.
Let me take y'all back to the beginning.
I'm a kid from Marcy Project from Brooklyn. The only way I was gonna achieve these things was through doing illegal activity. There was no other way out.
Luckily for me, I had a God-given talent.
Practice, never reenact this. The simple fact is I'm real good at this.
I had ability to speak about situations and emotions and feelings. That's really how I started writing music. And I'm J-A-Y-Z. Y'all know me. I wish you could write, cause you pay me all the rhymes. Rapping, I just used to do it as a hobby, but my man Jazz, he introduced me to the whole business.
But when he got a deal, it was like, what? You get paid for this? I had, you know, that fork in the road, be an entertainer or stay in the street. And, you know, once I took that right turn to be an entertainer, I never looked back. Yo, I'm making sure turn goes when the weather
froze. Yes, put away the leathers and put ice on the gold. Chilly with enough bail money to free a big will. That shit was flamboyant. Just felt like I wanted to be that.
It is arguably one of the greatest documents about the hustling life that any human being has ever created.
I'm not really with that mainstream thing. We went and we made our own company, Rockefeller Records. We don't depend on the industry for nothing. If you don't play my stuff on the radio, it's gonna be heard.
You gotta have confidence to believe that you can do it. That's tough, you know, for someone to say, you're wrong. And I'm gonna prove you wrong. From standing on the corners bopping to driving
some of the hottest cars New Yorkers ever seen. Hard Knock Life. When he dropped that record, that's when the whole world really had to recognize who he was and what he was about.
And then I knew then that everything had changed that moment. When the Remy's in the system, ain't no telling when I'm fucking, will I diss them? That's what they be yelling. My singles are more geared towards having fun. They're about dancing. Those are the records that, you know, people enjoy listening to while they're in the nightclub. You know why? Thug them, hug them, love
them, leave them, but I don't trust or need them. I most definitely hear songs as a woman and be like, oh, you wildin'. But I love Big Pimpin'. When that come on, I just feel like, ah. Heart cold and assassin. I got no passion. I got no patience. And I hate waiting.
Mike, get your ass into this. So you start having a relationship, you know, Ain't No will become Big Pimpin', will become Song Cry. So you see the growth even in the music. I can understand why you want a divorce now,
though I can't let you know it. Pride won't let me show it. Song Cry, that's a special song. I feel that song is about a man with no emotions using a form of music as a way to vent. Oh yeah, I see him coming down the
aisle, but I gotta let the song cry. Super gangster rappers coming to me like, yo, thank you for that. You know, they could tell me on the side, yo, you saved my relationship.
That's right. A to the is O, B to the is A, which is on my zoo, you sit dribble down at VA. H O B A, that's the anthem, get your damn hands up.
When I do things, I try to represent the culture in the positive light to show that we can mature. You know, I was a product of my environment, but as I grew and I got to see other things, you know, my sophistication level, it rose.
You know, what Jay does with the multiplicity of cadences that he's able to put forth is like a jazz musician.
I don't believe in those lines that people put up for music. I'm really a student of music. And every chance that I get, I've tried to cross genres. I'm an artist. It's my music. I can do what I want with it. That's the great thing about hip hop. When you're in a position to stretch the genre, you have to do it.
He actually brings another side out of the producers. He wasn't afraid to try new sounds.
In hip hop, we use our voice as our main instrument. You found the place in that track to tuck in, and you just don't disturb the groove, where it's just smooth and it just flows.
The year's 94 and the trunk is raw, and my rear view mirror is the motherfucking law. I got two choices, y'all. Pull over the car or bounce on the devil, put the pedal to the floor. And I ain't trying to see no highway chase with Jake, plus I got a few dollars I can fight the case.
I don't know if you ever done, right? It's almost like climbing a mountain, and you see another mountain, and you go to the next one and the next one. If you have a girl,
he has reached the masses for 14 albums at number one.
That type of run is like alien status. You gotta be a Jedi.
Allow me to reintroduce myself. My name is
I look at myself as an ambassador for hip hop to ascend to levels that other people haven't. I mean, as an artist.
You know, Jay always showed us peaks of, you know, his personal story. But I think with 444, this was the only moment where you seen him completely vulnerable. He took the cape off.
You'd have told me 20 years ago that my life would be like this. I'm not sure I would have believed you.
They'll never be able to stop us ever! Yeah, I'm out at Brooklyn. Now I'm down in Tribeca, right next to the narrow. But I'll be hood forever.
As you grew, we grew. Each step you take, the streets take it with you. I mean, you got nothing but love out here.
Thank you. I appreciate it, bro. History shall record your greatness. You leave your name here, so long after you're gone, people, they're looking at your name like, this guy stood for that, he meant that to us, and he did this for us. I would love to affect culture in such a way that you're remembered like that.
It is my honor to welcome to the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, Jay-Z.
Trying to make me cry in front of all these white people. I feel so honored to be celebrated in such a way. Thank you, Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. It's incredible honor. You know, growing up, we didn't think we could be inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. We were told that hip hop was a fad. And much like punk rock, it gave us this anti-culture, this subgenre, and there were heroes in it. When I was thinking of what I was gonna say tonight, these heroes just kept coming to my mind. Rakim and Big Daddy Kane and KRS-One and Chuck D, and of course a fellow, I don't know where he is, a fellow inductee, LL Cool J. And I would watch these guys and, you know, they have big rope chains and leather and sometimes even the red, black, and green medallions, and whatever they wore, everybody would wear the next day. And I was like, that's what I want to do. I want to be like those guys. And so I set out on my journey. You know, I was writing at my table. Shout out to Dr. Gloria Carter in the house. She bought me a green notebook. My sister, Annie, right there, she told me to say that she wrote my first rap, but I actually wrote her first rap, and we named the Sugar Love. She has a really nice hat on tonight, and I want everyone to acknowledge her hat. Now, that's rock and roll. And I would sit at the table, and I would write all these raps, and then I would go out in the street, and I would try these raps out, and I, you know, have little battles in the street. And, you know, Tata, who's sitting there, I would go to Tata and be like, yo, I'm the best, I'm telling you, I'm the greatest. Well, one of the greatest. I don't want no problems, LL. Like, one of the greatest. And I'll go to Tata, yo, I'm the greatest. And Tata be like, yeah, young, you are the greatest. And then I look back at some of those raps, and it was like, stop thinking you're making it, son. I'm breaking the break. It was trash, but somehow we knew. And then I went and recorded a demo with, shout out to Clark Kent, Brooklyn DJ, legendary Clark Kent. And I recorded a demo, and I went to every single record company, and you know what they say, right? That shit is trash. But the audacity of hip hop, we didn't believe them. I, for not one second, got depressed. For one second, I didn't change my course. It was like, we're gonna create our own company, you know? That's hip hop. So we made an album, Reasonable Doubt. You heard the album, just this one guy. And we came out and we sold about, I don't know, no copies, but we thought we made the greatest thing of all time. I actually remember at a Soul Train party running to LL. You know, LL says like bananas a lot. He's like, yo, can I live? That's just bananas, B. And I was like, wow, like my, you know, one of my heroes is like repeating this thing back. So I knew I was on the right track. And then we dropped the second album. Oops. I got too ambitious and I was doing some things that I shouldn't have been doing. And again, those heroes helped me again. I thought back to, you know, what made them so great. And what made them great is they was 100% authentic to who they were. LL, he opened up the doors for us to be vulnerable. When I'm alone in my room, I'm always just hanging around. Sometimes he gave us emotional intelligence. And then KRS-One, he was a teacher. And at that time, it wasn't even cool to be smart. Like if you had a book, they'd be like, look at this nigga with a book. And he made it cool for us to have books and be smart. Rakim gave us knowledge itself, and he had a big, vast vocabulary that he never cursed. And I was like, how is he saying all this fresh shit without cursing? And
Chuck D, he gave a social commentary, and that shit was slap. Like, all the songs was, like, amazing, like, slappers. And then, you know, Big Daddy Kane, he was just, like, a black exploitation film walking. Yeah. Like, he had, like, a flat top, and he could, like, rap hardcore and jump over his leg and do a split. It was, like, the blackest person of all time. You know? So I was like, oh, I got it. I got to be 100% authentically myself. That set the course of, you know, what I would do for the rest of my career. Then next album came, 99, and 2000, and 2001, and Grammys, and Songwriters Hall of Fame, and beautiful accomplishments. And then I got a phone call, and it was like, hello? Jay, it's Obama. I got to work on my Obama accent. And he called me and he said, you know, it's the fourth quarter, we're down two, and I need you to assist me. Give me the ball, I'm Michael Jordan, and I'll get this done. I need you to go to Miami, Philly, Atlanta, and Ohio. And I thought, like, man, hip hop is really an agent for change, and how amazing and the reach that this man is calling me to help out with a campaign. I'm lying, I didn't think that. I thought, nigga, I'm Michael Jordan. What are you talking about? That's what I really thought. But I did it, and I met him in Ohio, and we won. We got it done here in Ohio. And that just showed me the power of hip hop, the power of these heroes who let me know that these things are possible, and we're gonna enjoy tonight. I appreciate this honor. Sorry for this long-ass speech, but I had to get it off. We did!